Dear friends, in the previous lecture we have seen the fundamental physical quantities and there are the physical quantities. We have seen that there are the 7 fundamental quantities and 2 more additional quantities, they are called as supplemental quantities. And other than this, all quantities are called as derived quantities. Now in the physics, the fundamental quantities as well as derived quantities, they are distributed, they are divided into 2 groups. One is called as scalar quantity, other one is called as vector quantity. First, we will see what is meant by scalar quantity. Suppose that there is a 10 kg sugar. That is, we can say that the 10 kg sugar means the mass of the sugar is 10 kg. Mass of the sugar is 10 kg. From this sentence, that is, the mass of the sugar is 10 kg, we will get the complete information about this 10 kg sugar. Correct. Suppose that the length of the book or the length of the, suppose that the length of the table, that is the length of the table is 1 meter. That is, from this sentence we will get the correct information. That is, we will get the correct information only from this magnitude. Again, we can add 10 kg sugar is added to the 20 kg sugar. So, means total is 30 kg sugar. That is, from this we will get the correct information from their magnitude alone. Now the physical quantities which are described by only its magnitude, they are called as scalars. Simply you can say that the for the scalars we need only magnitude. That is, magnitude is only essential for these scalars. That is, we know that mass, length, time, temperature, area, volume, density, pressure, etc. These are called as scalar quantities. Now, what is the main characteristics of the scalar quantities? First is that the scalars, they need only magnitude. That is, the magnitude is sufficient for its complete description. If we describe the scalar in terms of magnitude, only magnitude is sufficient. And again, we know that these scalars, they can be added or subtracted by using a simple algebraic rules. Means we can add or subtract by using a simple algebraic rules. Means volume is added into volume. Suppose that there is a 10 liter water, it is added into 20 liter water, we will get the 30 liter water. Means they can be added. Or suppose that the sugar is 20 kg and from 20 kg sugar we have taken out 5 kg sugar, the remaining is 15 kg. Means they are added simply by using algebraic rules. So that we can say that for the scalars, magnitude is only sufficient. From the magnitude we will get the complete its description. Second is that we can add or subtract these quantities by using simple algebraic rules. But here should be taken that these quantities, they should be expressed in the same unit, either MKS or CGS or any other unit. That is, so that it is easy to measure or to count or to add or to subtract the quantities. Now this is about the scalars. Now we will see one more quantity that is very essential for us, that is called as a vector. We will see what is meant by the vector. Suppose that you are at a distance of 5 meter from this place. Suppose that this place is Bellary. And you are at a distance of 5 kilometer. And you ask your parent, just come and receive me. Then it is necessary for your parent to receive you because you told that you are at a distance of 5 kilometer. Then how he can locate you? Means if you have to locate the 5 kilometer from this Bellary center, he has to draw a circumference considering Bellary as a center and it is equal to 5 kilometer. And he will draw a circle and on this circumference you will be there. Correct? Means you cannot consider, we cannot tell that you are at a distance of 5 km from Bellary. From this sentence you will not get the complete descriptions. In this case you need a direction. Suppose that you are at a 5 km to the east of the Bellary, we can easily locate it. Means for such quantities to describe, we need a magnitude as well as a direction. that is both are missing, both are missing. Then we can say that it is vector. That is, vectors are the physical quantities which need magnitude as well as direction. Magnitude as well as direction. Then we can say that it is vector. Or for the complete description of vector, we need magnitude and directions. Now first, then we will see again what are the characteristics of the vectors. First we will see that in case of a vector, we need a magnitude as well as a direction. As well as a direction. Magnitude as well as the directions for the complete description. Again, these vectors they cannot be added or subtracted by using simple algebraic rules. That is, they are not added. They are not added or subtracted by using simple algebraic rules. Simple algebraic rules. For the representation of these vectors, we have to use the graphical method. Again, we know that for the addition and subtraction, so there are the triangle law, then the parallelogram law, polygon law. We will see later on. But just keep in mind that for the addition of vectors, we cannot use the simple algebraic rules. Means 2 plus 3, 3 plus 5 or 5 minus 3. These are simple algebraic cases. They are not used. They are not used in case of vectors. That is, we know that the displacement, velocity, acceleration, force, momentum, impulse, these are the vector quantities. These are the vector quantities. Correct? You see what the difference between the scalar and vector? Yes, yourself? Yeah, okay, good. That is, we need a scale. That is, we have to distinguish between the scalar quantity and vector quantity. Students, just tell me that what is the difference between the scalar quantity and vector quantity? Yes, anybody? Yeah, okay, good, good. Yes, yourself? I will write the scalar and vector quantities and you have to distinguish. Before this, we will see once again or we revise the difference between scalar quantity and a vector quantity. Scalar quantity and a vector quantity. Who will tell me about the scalar quantity and vector quantity? Okay, good. That is, for the scalar, we need a magnitude only. That is, the magnitude is sufficient. Okay, good. And for the vectors, we need a magnitude as well as a direction. Both are missing. Okay? Then we can add or subtract. We can add or subtract these scalars by using simple algebraic rules. Algebraic rules. Correct? But we cannot use the simple algebraic rules. Simple algebraic rules, they are not used. Again, we know that graphical methods are used for the vectors, they are not used in case of scalars. That is, no necessity of graphical methods. Graphical methods are, they are not useful. Graphical method. Again, in this case, vectors, we need graphical methods. Again, we know that in case of vectors, we show the vector by taking arrowhead. Suppose that this is the vector A. It means this is the notation for the vector A. And in case of the magnitude, we can write only A or the modulus of A. It shows the magnitude of the vector. Correct? Now this is the distinction between scalar and vector. Just keep in mind that. The examples is not a point of a distinguish. Correct? Just will for the for our knowledge, we can write only the examples. But examples are, they are not considered for the distinguish points between the scalar and vector. That is, example is not a distinguishing point between these two quantities. For my knowledge, or to know how you acquired this knowledge, just tell me that the examples of a scalar and vector. दैट इज द यस ओके मास लेंथ ओके टाइम टेम्परेचर डेंसिटी ओके गुड गॉट इट ओके दीज आर द स्केलर्स एंड व्हाट अबाउट द वेक्टर्स ओके या यस यू सेल्फ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ओके देन वेलोसिटी हाँ या देन एक्सेलरेशन फोर्स ओके गुड गुड यस यू गॉट इट दैट इज दीज आर द स्केलर्स एंड वेक्टर्स ओके फर्दर विल टेल मी दैट हाउ द वेक्टर्स दे आर डिनोटेड how the vectors they are denoted that is notation for the vector that is throughout this chapter we will consider only about the vectors okay that is in case of vectors suppose that is vector a we read as a vector a this is the vector a this is the vector a now in this case the length of the arrow shows indicates the matter of vector a and this arrowhead gives us the direction of the vector correct that is the length of the arrow gives the magnitude we know that for a vector we need magnitude as well as a direction but in this case the length of the arrow will give us information about the magnitude and the arrowhead gives us the direction correct again we know that suppose that is the vector b This is the vector b. Means this length of the arrow indicates the matter of the vector b, and this arrow head indicates the direction of a vector b. Correct? That is for the vector we need a magnitude as well as a direction. Magnitude as well as a direction. Suppose that the force of a 3 newton is acting. In a northeast direction. Suppose that the force of a 3 newton is acting in a northeast direction. Means the force vector quantity we know that 3 newton is a magnitude and northeast is a direction. Now we have to show it by graphical method. Suppose that this is the east, then this is the west direction. This is the south and this is the north. This is the north, and which is the northeast between the north and east. Now here is your force of 3 newton. Now just I will show that this is the our force. This is the 3 newton force is acting. Now this is the force 3 newton. You can suppose that we consider that 1 centimeter is equal to 1 newton. Then for the 3 centimeter we will get that 3 newton. So we can say that this is the 3 newton. This is the 3 newton force. Now in this case, the length of the arrow indicates the length of the arrow indicates the magnitude of the vector, and the arrowhead indicates the direction of the vectors. Now this is the graphical method. Now this figure shows that the force of 3 newton is acting in the northeast directions. Okay, you got it? Means for the representation of vector, we need a magnitude as well as a directions. Now how the vectors are shown by the arrowhead. If there is arrowhead, we can say that it is a vector. For example, this is the vector A, this is the vector B, this is the vector C, this is the vector D, and so on. And how you can show its magnitude? That is the simply write A, or in modulus you can write a vector A. It shows that this is the magnitude of the vector A. This is the magnitude of the vector B. Simply B means magnitude of vector B, or you can write in modulus vector B. That is the magnitude of the vector B. Correct? You got it? That is this simply A or B. This shows the magnitude of the vector A and B. Or you can write simply in modulus. This shows the magnitude of the vector A and vector B. Correct? Yes, you got it? How the vectors they are represented? That is, if there is notation of arrow, can say that it is vector. There is a vector. Just we have seen that. Just in the previous example, we can say that the force has a 3 newton magnitude. 3 newton magnitude. This force has a 3 newton magnitude. Its direction is a northeast direction. Now we have to see one more quantity that is called as equal vectors and opposite vectors. What is mean by the equal vector? Equal vector or equal vectors. Just that the vectors having the same magnitude and same directions, they are called as equal vector. suppose that this is the vector A and this is the vector B, then we can say that these are equal vectors because they have the same directions and they have the same magnitude. Correct? Then we can say that vector A and vector B, they are called as equal vectors. That is, vectors having the same magnitude and same directions. Same magnitude means they should be parallel. Okay? That is, they are called as equal vectors. Now, what is equal vectors? Vectors having the same magnitude and same directions, they are called as equal vectors. And just we'll see what is meant by the opposite vector. Opposite vector. Opposite vector or just called as a negative vector. Just called as a negative vector. That is, vectors having the same magnitude but opposite directions. Same magnitude but opposite directions. They are called as opposite vectors. Suppose that this is the vector x and this is the vector y. You can say that vector x and vector y, they have the same magnitude. Just see, they have the same magnitude but their directions are opposite. So they are called as opposite vectors. And thereby this is the equal vectors. Now what is the difference between equal vector and opposite vector? That is, vectors having the same magnitude and same directions, they are called as equal vectors. And vectors having the same magnitude but opposite directions, they are called as opposite vectors. Now I will draw some figures on the board and you have to identify that which are the equal vectors and which are the opposite vectors. It is very simple. It is very simple. Just see. I will draw the figures and you have to find out. This is the vector A, this is the vector B, this is the vector C, this is the vector D, this is the vector E, this is the vector F, and this is the vector G. And this is the vector G. Just I have drawn through some figures and you have to find out the vectors which are equal and which are opposite. Now what is our definition for the equal vectors? Vectors having the same magnitude and same directions. They are called as equal vectors. It is clear that vector A and vector B, both have the same magnitude, same directions, equal vectors. Okay, you got it? Again, we can say that vector A and vector D, A and D, they have the same magnitude, same directions. Again, they are equal vectors. Again, vector B and vector D, equal vectors. Again, you compare that vector A, vector B, vector D, vector F. Okay? They are equal vectors. They are equal vectors. They have the same directions. Now just see, vector B and vector C, they have the same magnitude but direction is opposite. So that vector B and vector C, they are called as opposite vector or a negative vector. Vector A and vector C, they are called as opposite or a negative vectors. Vector D and vector C, they are called as opposite vectors. And what is wrong about vector D and vector F? Yeah, you are wrong. Vector D and vector F, they are a equal vectors. They are equal, but just see, vector D and F, they have the same magnitude, same directions. So vector D and vector F, they are the equal vectors. Yes, what is your opinion about the vector E and vector G? Yeah, correct, you got it. These are called as opposite vectors. Okay, vector E and vector F, sorry, vector E and vector G, they are opposite vectors. Okay, in this way we have seen what is meant by the scalar, its examples. What is meant by the vector, its examples. And what are the distinguishing features, points between vector A and vector B. Again, we have seen that what is meant by the equal vector, what is meant by the opposite vectors, and again we have seen by this examples, that is, we have seen above which are the equal vectors and which are the opposite vectors. So students, we will stop here and in the next lecture we will see how the vectors they are added and how the vectors they are separated. Okay, just enjoy our channel SSV. Okay, all the best. Thank you.